Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Gayatri's Chemistry. Today our topic is stereochemistry. In that we have to learn what is Fischer projection, Newman projection and Sohr's projection. Let's begin the topic, what is Fischer projection. The stereo aspects of organic chemistry are well understood by the three-dimensional models. So let an example take lactic acid. Let's take an example, lactic acid. The lactic acid is CHOH CH3COOH. This is the formula of lactic acid. How we have drawn the Fischer projection for lactic acid? See, in Fischer projection, first we have to draw two lines. One is horizontal line, while the other is a vertical line. One is horizontal line, other one is a vertical line. So, if this is an observer, if the groups or the bonds that are nearer or that are towards the observer present on horizontal line, means here H and OH are present, the bonds that are far from the observer are present on vertical lines, that means CH3COOH. What in Fischer projection, we have taken horizontal line and vertical line, in those are in right angle 90 degree. So if the bonds that are towards the observer, they are coming towards the observer on horizontal line, if the bonds away from the observer placed on vertical lines. So in these Fischer projection, two enantiomers are present. Let's see what are enantiomers. Two enantiomers. Enantiomers. So, how when the groups are interchanged, the enantiomers are formed. How the enantiomers are formed? When the groups are interchanged, means for example, OH and H are interchanged, so we get the enantiomer. So, 1 and 2 structures are enantiomers of this one. Because see here, OH and H are interchanged. This is one enantiomer. In the same way, CH3 and COOH groups are interchanged. So, this is another enantiomers. In Fischer projection, enantiomers are formed. So, what is Fischer projection? In Fischer projection, we have taken the horizontal lines, the bonds towards the observer placed on horizontal lines, in the same way bonds away from the observer placed on vertical lines, and the central atom carbon, that is a chiral carbon, present on center. Where the chiral carbon is present? The chiral carbon is present in this center, that is chiral carbon. Next term is Newman's projection. The second one is Newman projection. Newman projection. So, let's take an example, ethane. Let an example take ethane, that is CH3CH3. In ethane, see, this is a front carbon and this is a back carbon. For example, here is the observer, the carbon nearer to the observer is a front carbon, and the carbon far from the observer, that is a back carbon. So what happens here? How we can draw the Newman projection for this ethane? So the front carbon, this is as a point. The front carbon that is taken as point, from this three hydrogens are attached. To this front carbon, three hydrogens are attached, and the back carbon is drawn as a circle around the point. The back carbon is drawn as a circle around the point, and here that also has three hydrogens. That also has three hydrogens, and the angle between the 120 degrees. So this is a staggered form. This is a staggered form where dihedral angle is 60 degrees. And another one is eclipsed form. Another one is eclipsed form. So see, in eclipsed form, H front carbon, that is back carbon, to this back carbon, H. Here the angle, dihedral angle is zero. This is eclipsed form. This is eclipsed form where dihedral angle is zero. What in Newman projection, the carbon nearer to the observer is drawn as a point. So the carbon away from the observer is a circle around this point. So here the dihedral angle in staggered form is 60 degrees, where the dihedral angle in eclipsed form is 0 degrees. This is a Newman projection. Next one is a Shawhorse projection. Next one is Shawhorse projection. What is Shawhorse projection? Shawhorse projection. So here also I can take example as ethane, that is CH3. In the Shawhorse projection, the bond between two carbon atoms, two carbons are present, so that form bond. The bond between two carbon atoms are a straight line, but they are slightly tilted. That means they are like this. The bond between two carbon atoms are slightly tilted. Here the first carbon, second carbon. Here this is first carbon and this is a second carbon. To this three hydrogens are attached. H. To this also carbon hydrogens are attached. See, this is eclipsed form. This is a eclipsed form where dihedral angle is 0 degree. What in Shawhorse projection, the bond between two carbon atoms is a straight line and slightly tilted. So here the angle between C and H is 120 degrees. What is the angle? That is 120 degrees. Another form is staggered form. In the staggered form, this is one carbon that has a H, and this carbon also has a H, and this is a staggered form. What? This is a staggered form where angle theta is equal to 60 degrees. Angle theta is equal to 60 degrees. What is Shawhorse projection? In Shawhorse projection, the bonds are formed between carbons are slightly tilted. Here also eclipsed form and staggered form also present. So to understand the organic compounds better, we have drawn those structures in three-dimension forms by taking Newman's projection, Shawhorse projection and Fisher's projection. Thank you.